What is a voyage? It's a long journey with many storms, and you have to weather them all to get to the end of that voyage. No one said, this is your journey, this is your path, this is what's next, this is what lies ahead. I just knew that I wanted more, that I wanted to get better, that there was always a next. I feel like the fun is just now starting, right? It's been 6 years, but now I'm just having fun with it. So my voyage just got longer.
And at WrestleMania, we will also debut the symbol of that evolution, the WWE Women's Championship.
I believe we were in Brooklyn when that was announced by Stephanie. You could just tell everyone was so excited. I mean, everyone was like, I'm gonna win this first. I mean, they weren't saying that, but you could see everyone's eyes on the prize because it looked so cool and it was so drastically different than the Divas title. I mean, yeah, it looked like the men's title. I think it's hard to feel or see what it means in the moment, but really that they were making a change as a whole for the women, and I was a part of that. And that they were giving us more opportunities, more time, more storylines. We were a focal point of that WrestleMania. And up until then, I think AT&T was announced as the biggest. And I was just growing into the Divas title as well when I won that title from Nikki. When you saw Nikki walk out, you were like, whoa, that's a star. Like when I was walking out, I was still like, where do I put my hands? What do I wear? How do I smile? How do I walk? Does this look okay? Like second guessing every step, fake it till you make it, right? But not until I won WrestleMania 32, when the referee handed me that title, I was like, okay, I don't feel like the title owns me, I own it. And I think it was that no one was going, wow, that was a great women's match. No, that was just a great match. And that's what the three of us did that day on the grandest stage together. So when I held that title, I was like, yeah, I'm an equal. That wasn't the hard part. That was the fun part. It was just making sure that it all came together at the right time, and it did. The word revolution felt really big at the time, but it wasn't something that we didn't think that we could accomplish. We wanted to give them women's wrestling. We wanted to steal the show. We wanted, you know, to show that we could be the main event because we had been in NXT. Here you have three girls from NXT who possibly are gonna steal the night at WrestleMania 32 in the biggest WrestleMania to date. Like, that is unheard of. Like, that match started the revolution. It was the first time I did the spin because I had the robe. Like, the timing and the music and just, like, I was just growing into everything. There wasn't really, like, I wasn't the full package. And that moment was still so memorable for that night and what we did, but so much doubt, so much uncertainty, so much learning to do. Now when I walk out, like, I can picture my entrance. I can picture what it feels like to be in front of 101,000 people. It's hard to explain. I'm just grateful. I still, like, wake up in the morning. I don't know how I got so lucky. When I think of moments, like I'll never forget that. So when I walk out here, I'm just, you fast forward, it's just like a blink of an eye. It feels like yesterday.
You are not special. You are just first. I'll see you at WrestleMania.
I hear the name Ronda Rousey, I'm like, that's badass, right? But there's no doubt in my mind that in this realm of what I do in sports entertainment, no one's better than me. I don't care your name. I don't care how tough you are. You think you're the baddest woman on the planet? I know how bad I am. You want a main event? Well, I am the main event here. Like, it's not, I don't look at it as I have to beat Ronda. No, Ronda has to beat me. But I think I opened that door to make that dream a reality, to find an equal with someone that could go toe-to-toe with her, that's not afraid of her. A lot of that has to do with how much I respect her, but there is that, you know, little piece of me that goes, yeah, you're welcome. No one knows the squared circle better than I do. This is in my blood. This is my legacy. This is, like, being the WWE Women's Champion means everything to me, and it has since 2015. What I'm fighting for in this industry, no one could understand. And that's the opponent that she's facing. Is it's not just a win. It's not just a Mania main event. It's not just, you know, a big match for Charlotte Flair. It's her brother's dream. It's her legacy. It's her father's legacy. It's a family legacy. It's a family business. It's where all my love and passion, and I love this business. I'll be here as champion. I'll be here when I win. I'll be here when I lose. So I fight for so much more than just, you know, becoming the SmackDown Women's Champion. This is in my blood. We'll be right back.